Hi, everyone, and welcome to TLDR.
We're in Las Vegas at the Mandalay Bay Convention Center for Cloud Next.
Over the next 3 days, we'll share the latest innovations from Google Cloud for customers, partners, and developers.
We're here for an up-close look at what this year's Cloud Next has to offer.
Let's go! First up, let's head to the keynote. Google Cloud CEO Thomas Kurian and team announced our latest advancements all across Google Cloud, including our AI hypercomputer, foundation models, Vertex AI platform, Gemini for Google Cloud and Workspace, and more. And we're off to the show floor. This year's Cloud Next is our first in Las Vegas and our biggest yet. Here to tell us more is our head of cloud marketing, Allison Wagenfeld.
So we moved Cloud Next to Vegas this year so that we could be bigger and better. We went from 15,000 people last year in San Francisco to 30,000 people in Vegas this year. And then we have more partners than we've ever had. One of my favorite parts of Cloud Next is how all of the customer stories have come to life on the show floor, getting a chance to actually get behind the scenes of how companies like Home Depot and UPS and Bayer and McLaren are using Google Cloud.
We got to check it out for ourselves. UPS is using the Google Cloud platform to design routing software for delivery drivers that reduces fuel consumption by 10 million gallons a year. They're also using RFID and wireless technology and package labels to improve sorting, visibility, and tracking. And we heard directly from McLaren.
Hi, I'm Ed Green, Head of Commercial Technology at McLaren Racing. So we've been working with a team at Google Cloud across a number of performance projects to help the cars go faster, get more race insights. Well, we've been using AI for a long time inside McLaren. And the idea here is to show attendees some race scenarios, what happens if the car's running out of fuel, what happens if the brakes are getting too hot, the tires are degrading. And sometimes we've got to make those decisions in 3 seconds. So the whole game's been developed in collaboration with race engineers to give those real world examples of how we're using data and AI to inform our race strategy.
Next up, the Google Cloud Showcase. Our own showcase features the latest from Google across AI, workspace, security, infrastructure, and more. We saw our new AI-powered video creation app, Google Vids, in lights, camera, action. Then got an up-close look at our hardware and AI hypercomputer architecture, including our most powerful TPU accelerator, the V5P, and the new Axion processor, which brings better performance and efficiency to our Google Cloud data centers. We used Gemini to explore Earth's biodiversity and tried our hand, or foot, at penalty kicks. Pixel devices captured the kick spatially, used Vertex AI to analyze technique, and then used the results to provide personalized coaching insights from Gemini. Time to check out the Innovators Hive. This space is a dedicated hub for developers to discover everything new in Google Cloud. There's a coding hub with hackathons and a Kaggle competition, lightning talks and tech training zones, and of course, live demos. Here to tell us more is Gabe Monroy, who leads Google Cloud's Developer Experience Group.
I think there's two announcements, both really in the AI assistant space that stand out to me. The first one is what we're doing with full code base awareness in Gemini Code Assist. Thanks to our Gemini Pro 1.5 model and our large million token context window, we're able to take the entire repository, all of the files in your code base, and provide AI suggestions that use all of the information inside of your repo. Super accelerating for developers. And then the second one is a product called Gemini Cloud Assist, which we're announcing in Next here, which is really around helping developers operate throughout the entire application lifecycle, whether that's designing their app, troubleshooting their app, optimizing their app, you know, things outside of just the software authoring process. I'm really excited that a lot of the work that we've done internally inside of Google are starting to trickle out into some of the products that we're announcing. And I think it's really important that, you know, we continue to live up to that idea of taking the best of what's working inside of Google and making that available to customers.
We explored the rest of the Expo floor to see the latest offerings from other companies and how they're using Google Cloud to boost performance and productivity. There were snacks, demos, prizes, a Vegas-style dance-off, some friendly competition, and puppies. Cloud Next also featured dedicated networking and talk spaces for startups, and an inclusion lounge with workshops and coaching, panels and networking events, headshots, and a collaborative mural. There, we ran into Melanie Parker, Google's Chief Diversity Officer.
I'm really excited on the panel that I'm moderating with startups. We're going to talk about how starting small allows you to build more inclusive teams right from the very beginning. The second panel is with Eve and Dimitri, and we're talking about accessibility. We're going to preview some technology that shows how we're able to generate more inclusive content so that we can better communicate to one another.
It wouldn't be Cloud Next without our partners. Before we left, we got to meet our new lead of channels and partner programs, Colleen Kopse.
This is definitely my first time at Next. It's absolutely huge. Partners are really at the heart of everything that we're doing with AI and part of Google Cloud. They're here developing solutions, learning skills, and showing what our technology can do all the way to the last mile for our customers. We have partners in every single country, across every single one of our technologies, with expertise in every single industry. I've seen everything from a robotic dog to manufacturing solutions. It's amazing.
And that's a wrap on Cloud Next 2024.
Hey, thanks for tuning in.
We'll see you next time.
Bye, everybody.